हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू अवर इंग्लिश क्लास। दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश टीचर अलमास। वी आर हैविंग हियर अ ब्यूटीफुल वचना। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वचना, दैट इज टेम्पल एंड अ बॉडी। बिफोर मूविंग टू द पोएम, लेट अस नो अबाउट द राइटर एंड द ट्रांसलेटर। दिस पोएम वॉज रिटन बाय बसवन्ना। इट वॉज ट्रांसलेटेड बाय ए के रामानुजन। A. K. Ramanujan was born on 1929 and died on 1993. A. K. Ramanujan is a renowned poet of English and Kannada. Now let us know about the poet. The name of the poet is Basavanna. He was born on 1106. He was a great social reformer who strove to build a new social order free from caste, class and orthodoxy. He was the leader of the medieval religious movement. Veerashaivism, of which the Kannada Vachanas are the most important text. Akka Mahadevi, Alama Prabhu, Devara Dasi Maya are some of the other great Veerashaiva poets. Basavanna died on 1168. Now let us move to the poem. It is the third poem of the first language English. Particularly this poem is for memorization. So, before we discuss Vachana, I will read it. Listen carefully. The rich will make temples for Shiva. What shall I, a poor man, do? My legs are pillars, the body the shrine, the head a cupola of gold. Listen, O Lord, of the mating rivers. Things standing shall fall, but the moving ever shall stay. Now let us move to the first stanza explanation. In this first stanza, Basavanna expresses his helplessness because he could not build the temple of a cement and bricks like a rich people. The rich people are able to build a temple to prove their devotion. A feeling of a strong love and worshipping to God Shiva. But he is unable to do so because he is very poor. So Basavanna asks himself that what he can offer to compete with that. What temple can he build to offer proper worship to God Shiva? Now we can move to the explanation of second stanza. Here a word cupola means a small rounded dome. We can call it as kalasha. Here Basavanna gives us a solution to the problem in this particular stanza. First of all, Basavanna compares between the temple and a human. Make our body as a temple, and he tells us that our legs are pillars, body is a temple, and a head is a cupola of gold. Basavanna believes that as a poor we cannot build temple like a rich people to show our devotion to God. So he considered his body itself as a temple of God, because God is host in the soul of men. So it is very simple and gives the solution for that. And the last three lines. Here, Lord of mating rivers means Basavanna choose Lord Shiva at Kudala Sangama. Thing standing means the solid or unmoving temple. The word moving means human beings. In the third stanza, Basavanna addresses that the Lord of the mating rivers. Listen word means he made an appeal to his spiritual god Shiva at Kudala Sangama, that all material things are on his earth will perish one day. Man-made temples of a stone will fall down. will destroy one day. It is not permanent. Same way, richness of a showing of false devotion is not permanent. But true devotion, which is permanent in human body, we can call it as a soul. Soul will remain forever. Good deeds done by us will remain forever, which he compares to temple is forever. It moves from generation to generation. Totally in this vachana, Basavanna brings out the idea of a permanent spiritual things and impermanent of material things. All material things are going to destroy one day. Only a devout soul that move according to the God will stand forever. At the end, we can ultimately come to a conclusion that in this vachana, Basavanna expresses that rich people built a temple to proclaim the glory of God, but poor Basavanna confesses that he is unable to do so. What these people do? So he says that he is going to dedicate his own body as a temple of God. So we can understand that Basavanna brings out the idea of permanent of a spiritual things and impermanent of material things, and with that he expresses the extreme devotion to the Lord Shiva.